Hello, Mom, Dad, and Ariel. I have something I want to tell you, and I know you'll be proud of me. I have just purchased RATP stock of the Fullington Auto Bus Company, which makes me the first Fullington to own 100% of the company since my great-grandfather Emerson, who passed away in 1918, almost 100 years ago. It's hard to believe that in 2018, the company will be 110 years old. Back in February, RATP informed me they wanted to sell their stock, and I knew then that I could not let them sell it to just anyone, not to a mergers and acquisition company, not to a venture capitalist, or anyone that could jeopardize our employees' jobs and our company's name. Ariel, now be quiet. I know you would not want me to do this. You protected me all your life and wanted me to slow down. But you have to remember why we sold the majority of our stock in the first place. We wanted our family name to go on forever and didn't want anyone to lose their jobs. We have a wonderful team of employees. And Ariel, under Jonathan's leadership and with everyone's help, we have grown the company over the last 6 years. Dad, you would be proud. We have added Beaver's line runs from Harrisburg to Scranton. And this past September, we have picked up Susquehanna Trailway's line runs to Elmira, Harrisburg, New York City, and Philadelphia. I know how much you and Mom love Trailways. We also acquired the Bellefonte and Southern Columbia school bus contracts. Mom and Dad, you won't believe it, but Barry McClellan is still here after 53 years. Your third son, Terry Welker, is still plugging away. Mel Knepp oversees maintenance for our 212 school buses. Godfrey Fodor is still taking care of Penn State football. And Jackie Rhodes still helps Lori and I. Dad and Ariel, I know you wanted a CFO, and Bob, our current CFO, is really good. You would like him. I have a lot of other people to talk about, but you will have to keep looking down on us from heaven to hear about them. Please tell the Lord to continue watching over us. I love and miss you. Wow, I just love that song. How about you? Well, Lori, it's time for you and I to greet our wonderful employees. But I have one more person to thank. This is your second surprise. A lot of you heard me say I have been around a long time. Well, look at this picture. I was about 8 years old in 1962. Proof, I have been working a long time. I remember the day quite well because my dad told me he loved me, and I can count on three fingers how many times he said that to me. Even though he hardly ever said so, I knew I could depend on him, and I knew he would always be there when I needed his help. My mother started working for the company at a young age when women didn't work. I could always depend on her. Mom was a tough lady. My sister Ariel came on board in 2003 when the company was close to bankruptcy, so she could help me out. Ariel was always there when I needed her and was also an incredibly tough lady. I know I never wanted to have an Ariel meeting. One person who has always been by my side for the last 38 years is my lovely wife, Lori.
You once, twice, three times a lady. I love you. Yes, you once, twice, three times a lady.
I want to go back in time to tell you how my purchasing the stock from RATP came to be. On February 23rd of this year, RATP told me they were going to sell their shares of the Fullington stock. I had the option of selling my shares, 25%, to RATP if I wanted to. Then in March, after the initial shock of learning that they wanted to sell their shares, Jonathan said, "Why don't you buy the company back?" I immediately met with the banks to see their level of interest to loan me the money to acquire RATP's shares. The banks were very excited about the deal and the continued partnership, and that a Fullington would have 100% ownership of this great company again. After meeting with the banks, I went home and asked Lori if she was on board with us purchasing the company back. You need to know that if we would have sold stock to RATP, Lori and I could have retired early. Lori's exact words were, "What will happen to Jackie Rhodes and Terry Welker and Jonathan and to all our employees that depend on Fullington for their jobs?" And I said to her, as when Ariel and I sold 51% of the company to RATP 8 years ago, we stipulated that no one would lose their job, and that's what's going to happen again now. After Lori approved of the idea, the purchase price was agreed upon, then the next thing was getting a letter of commitment from PNC Bank and a letter of intent to buy the company back. The purchase agreement was finalized in September, but before I signed the purchase agreement, which bound Lori and I to buy the company, I asked Lori one more time, if I should die before the end of December, do you want to own this company? Her reply was, yes. After working for a long time, my wife of 36 plus years, who has had to put up with my father, mother, brother, and his wife, and my sister. This doesn't include Milt because he is just wonderful. A really nice guy. I know you all think I am so nice all the time, but she also had to put up with me. She has allowed me to fulfill the lifelong dream my father had promised me when I was a young boy, that I was going to own Fullington Bus Company. There is a saying that behind every great man, there is a great woman, and I can't thank you enough, Lori, for always being by my side. I love you. To all our wonderful employees, I don't have a GMC dealership or any other aspirations in my life except to make the Fullington Auto Bus Company a great company you can be proud of and enjoy working for, and together, I know we can accomplish this. I like this video stuff because I know when I get on stage, I'll cry. So I would like to talk about some of the older people who worked for us in the past, because this night is not about me, it's about you, the people, and all of you current employees that make this company great. Loretta Wagner was a longtime HR director and helped Ariel when she came to the bus company. Andy Van Zura was a longtime motor coach driver who also supervised our operation in Fort Drum from 2003 to 2006. Ann Harper was a tour escort and also helped out in the tour department. She especially enjoyed escorting Penn State Bowl trips and New York City. B. Kane, known to us as B, worked in our State College Charter Department and continued to work for us after she retired. Bill Kelly worked as a limousine driver and motor coach driver. He drove limo for Mom, Dad, Dickie, and Ariel's funeral. Hopefully, he will not be driving for mine. Bill Long was a longtime dispatcher that came to us from Blue and White Lines. Reverend Bob Rohrbaugh started driving motor coach in 1964. He was someone that I called on regularly when I needed a driver at the last minute, except for Sundays, of course. Bob Wilson was one of the original Trailways drivers that came to Fullington Trailways in 1981. Bonnie Lucas worked in the State College office for a long time as a receptionist and helped with whatever needed done. Brenda Alexander drove limousine for many years. Not only did she present herself in a professional way, always in her tux, she took pride in keeping her vehicle clean at all times. Butch Fetzer was a longtime mechanic and motor coach driver. He is another driver that I could count on to help me in a moment's notice and would go anywhere. He could stay awake forever. Carl Nagel worked in our Clearfield office as a dispatcher with my mother and also drove motor coach when needed. Charlie Schaefer was my mom and dad's chief operating officer in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. Dale Taylor was a longtime motor coach driver. He had his own bus, and you would regularly see him shining the wheels and cleaning the interior and somehow put up with Jackie Rhodes. Ed Goodrow was a longtime mechanic and motor coach driver with a big personality that could bullshit with the best of us. Ed Rothrock was another longtime mechanic and motor coach driver that would do just about anything you ask him to do. Marge Pressler was Mom and Dad's first tour escort. Her goal was to visit all 50 states by bus, and I think she came close. Some people called her Sarge because she liked being in charge. She was close to our family, even planning Lori's first baby shower. Arlo Sessions drove motor coach and the Clearfield Town Bus. When I was a little kid, I would walk down to the corner and get on Arlo's bus and ride around Clearfield. Frank Robbins was a longtime motor coach driver and line run driver out of Dubois. Jerry Grube helped my mother with accounting in the Clearfield office in the 60s and 70s. Gary Fluke was a longtime motor coach and school bus driver who helped out in our safety department. He told me in 2001, following 9/11, that he and his pastor prayed that he would find a job, and the next day I called him to go on the road and sell charters for us. Hank Philippi was maybe not the best looking guy, but was a great driver that was requested to drive for many groups. He and I would fight like cats and dogs, but we had great respect for each other. Jack Fritz was our Dubois Trailways manager for many years, starting in 1981 when we joined the Trailways Corporation. Jack Knepp was Mel Knepp's dad. I didn't really know him, but he helped my mother, father, and my brother when needed, and they had great respect for him. Jack McNutt came to us in 1981 and was one of the original Fullington Trailways drivers. Jack Castaney came to us in 2006 as Ariel's third CFO and did a lot of work to finalize the sale of Fullington Bus to RATP. Jerry Fulmer worked as a dispatcher in our Clearfield office and took care of Diesel, the office cat. Jerry Moss was a longtime motor coach driver who also helped out in the garage and, like Ed Goodrow, could bullshit with the best of them. Jim Rhodes was a motor coach driver in the 80s that was requested by many groups. John Higby came to us in 2004 as Ariel's second CFO. He only stayed a couple years, but was instrumental in separating Fullington Bus and Fullington GMC. Junior Burkett was a mechanic for Trailways and Dubois in 1981 when we joined the Trailways Corporation. Judge Zimmer was hired by Ariel to head our safety division following his retirement as chief of police in Clearfield. J. Dell Matteson was a longtime motor coach driver that helped out between his farming chores. Kelly McCracken was our longtime controller that my father trusted and was very dedicated to her job. Buddha and Johnny were longtime mechanics in our Clearfield garage. I don't know who the other two are, but this picture is up there so you can see a young Mel Knepp and Terry Welker. They've been around a long time. Paul Hoover was a longtime motor coach driver and Dad's first safety director for Fullington Bus. Mike Geyer was our fourth CFO who came on board after RATP took over. This is a picture of me when I was 8 years old loading luggage on a bus that my dad was driving to Arizona. Just proof again that I've been around a long time. Milt Wiseman followed my sister to Clearfield in 2003 to help me and Fullington Bus when we were in financial difficulties. Milt became our director of trailways and was instrumental in acquiring grants for wheelchair lifts, safety equipment, and three free motor coaches from the Obama stimulus package. He is also my brother, and God bless him for taking care of my sister. Oscar Flory came to us when he was 15 years old. He drove to State College from Reedsburg without a license. He worked tirelessly for 48 years, and I got my work ethic from watching him, and he taught me most of my mechanic skills. Phil Quick. Phil's picture is here with past employees, and I believe he is sitting in the crowd. I call on him every once in a while to help in the shop. Phil came to us after he served in the Vietnam War. He left, but came back in the late 90s. He is a really good mechanic that everyone respects. Rich Parshall was a longtime motor coach driver out of Dubois. Rod Emenheiser and Earl Stewart. Rod was a longtime motor coach driver who was a very likable guy. Earl Stewart, along with his wife Dot, started their own travel agency and traveled together on many Fullington tours. Sam Scaife was a longtime motor coach driver who loved telling jokes. His favorite was, "How many fingers do I have up?" Shawnee Bennett worked in the State College office as a charter coordinator and helped my wife with all aspects of the company. One of the things I remember about Shawnee was my mother complaining about her big hair. She now works for the Clearfield Area School District as their transportation manager and continues to support Fullington Bus. Steve Kondo was a longtime motor coach driver who also managed our State College Trailways terminal in the 80s and 90s. Tom Fairman was one of the original Trailways drivers that came to us in 1981 and retired this past year after 36 years. Elaine Kitko started working in the State College office as Lori's assistant, but then moved to Clearfield and became our tour manager and retired when our tour department moved to State College. Al Morrow came to us from California. He was a motor coach driver and managed our Phillipsburg school bus division. Al and I drove the 32-day California tour when I was 21 years old. He told me when we left, there would be a day that he would not let me eat breakfast. That day came when we got to the Big Texan Steakhouse in Amarillo, Texas, and I ate a 72-ounce steak with baked potato, salad, shrimp cocktail, and roll, and because I ate it within an hour, I didn't have to pay for it. He was a gentleman. Julius Yonke. I could not find a picture of Julius. He was a longtime motor coach driver that my mother and father would send on long tours with the best groups and considered him their number one driver. He was a real ladies' man and knew how to take care of our customers. Julius was also a great mentor to me when my dad sent me to Ridgeway to be a mechanic in 1974. Okay, Lori, it's time for you and I to meet our employees.